Hi Gothos, welcome back to my channel where I react to the greatest moments in music. Very serious there.
Sometimes I feel I'm gonna break down and cry. Nowhere to go, nothing to do with my time. I get lonely, so lonely. Living on my own.
Okay, if I seem a bit somber, I'm still trying to recover from a documentary I just saw downstairs. Okay, be that as it may, very dance. Well, the whole album, Mr. Bad Guy, from 1985. Okay. Had that disco pulse running the whole way through. I love Freddie's, you know, during his lifetime with Queen, and certainly by his Todd, you know, he embraced so many musical genres, you know, some the critics panned him for, and Queen, you know, I remember, you know, Hot Space being viewed very suspiciously in the 80s. That one didn't go down awfully well. Incidentally, I have not heard this song, I would probably say, since I was 15. Because my best friend at the time, I hated him. because he got this album before me. Back when the big buzz on the street was, you've got a CD player, a CD separate attached to, the hi-fi. What's your album? Freddie Mercury, Mr. Bad Guy. I hate you. I hate you. And he wouldn't allow me to anywhere near it. He probably knew I would nick it. Totally steal it. I just wanted to drop that in as a memory. Just say, I'm sorry, but can I just say how much I love the beat running, galloping, steam rolling through this song. I just love this kind of, because it's quite infectious, isn't it? You know, as songs go, you know. No matter where you are, what you're doing, as soon as that hits the radio, you can't help but kind of, you are no longer in control of your own body. It kind of, it's a pill on that level. It is something. Okay. His placement on that, lonely, lone. I'm just trying to work out what he's doing here. Love it. Okay, guess our word is Freddie.
Down on me, I go crazy.
Okay, just before we get to that bit. I'd just like to speak how I love his album dedication. Okay, you know, within the inlay sleeve, this album is dedicated to, and usually people like, you know, my mother and father were a huge inspiration. I draw heavily on, and you get that. Freddie dedicates this, and I think this is so sweet, this album to his cat. I think there's a group of them, isn't there? You know, well, this cat is called Jerry, okay? And I think one of them is called Tom as well, and another name. You know, I think there's about three or four. And I think that is so typical Freddie, you know, because he adored his cats. He absolutely, it was a love unlike, you know, it was really special. I mean, we remember he wore that waistcoat in... Was it I'm Going Slightly... No, it's the last one. The one that I can't watch. Seriously, I have a breakdown. I'm like on the floor. I'm not even joking, guys. I can't watch it. I've only ever watched it once in my life. And, you know... These Are the Days of Our Lives. Okay, and he had on that cute waistcoat, cat waistcoat. So he clearly adored his cats. And there's such a sweet black and white photo on the internet I remember seeing with him looking, you know, pretty ill, you know. And he had a sea of cats, and I just thought, that's just perfect. Out of something so tragic. I have to say, when I first heard this, at whatever age I was, when it got to that part, I misheard the lyrics, and I couldn't understand why he was singing about monthly visits, because I got this image, well, the song must be about prison. Just a memory. I mean, every time I listen to Freddie, watch Freddie, and I don't want this to sound cringy, corny, cheesy at all, because it really isn't meant, you know, as such, but legends don't die. You know, true legends, you know, of this standard, this level, will never die. I don't have no time for no monkey business. Okay, sorry, I will make this quick. Okay, a monkey business. And the way he releases it, very it's very that, you know, and it's beautifully packaged, you know, love it. Isn't it funny the things you remember? I definitely remember that. And kind of, you know, holding myself almost because I couldn't wait for that part of the song. It's like, it was full of, oh God, that takes me back, you know. I'm just trying to work out, you know, get it together, Nat. The the instruments, and like, is there a bell in there, or is it me interpreting something completely different? You know, interpreting something that's not there at all, and my ears are, you know, obviously, you know, not listening to this at all, but I'm sure I detected a bell. It might be me. It might just be me, actually. There is definitely something there. I thought it might be me, you know, because that does happen, you know. If it's not a bell, it must be something else with a high, because I'm definitely detecting that something there, you know. Love it, absolutely. Is that the original? It's been such a long time since I sat down with this album. I must react to, you know, the 87. But that was the remix version from 1993. And that's the one that I do remember growing up with. But, yeah. All right, then. I think that's where we will... All right, then, gothies. I think that's where we'll leave things for this one. Thank you so much for sticking around for this reaction. Much appreciated. If this was your first glimpse into my weird... gothic world, and like what you see, please consider hitting the sub button that way. It helps me and my channel out a great deal. It means that I rank better on YouTube. I'm saying that like I understand, but I don't. I'm so not, you know, a proper YouTube. Okay, you're only getting about 2 a week until my move is sorted. Sorry about that, Gothies, but that's the way it has to be until all the chaos is sorted. I don't know when your next one will be from me, but it will be sometime this week. Feel free to stalk me on social media, links down there. Have a cracking week and I will see you real soon. Bap and bosh.